Mr. Batten, for 2.5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam President. Every time we think that things can't get worse, they do. Every time Mrs. May gets up to speak, we think that she may say something to resolve the situation. Instead, she just sinks lower into tragedy and farce. Now she's handing the Brexit hot potato to Jeremy Corbyn, and apparently the European Union will decide whether we take part in the European elections or not. Now, has the whole Brexit process fiasco been an elaborate conspiracy between Mrs. May and the EU, or is it just due to her monumental incompetence? Either way, we have to hand it to you, Mr. Juncker, Mr. Barnier. You have done what Philip of Spain, what Napoleon, what Kaiser Wilhelm and Hitler couldn't do. You have brought Britain to its knees without firing a single shot. But you could not have done any of these things without the connivance of the traitors, quislings and collaborators in the British Parliament and British establishment. As Seneca said, a nation cannot survive treason from within, and treason it is. Mrs. May and the Tories planned to betray Brexit from the start. They have betrayed it by means of delaying and impeding with the intention of finally overturning it altogether and setting aside the decision of the referendum. Many of the 17.4 million people in the UK who voted Leave now believe that their vote is pointless. But Britain is still nominally a democracy, and the vote is the only weapon that ordinary people have. Those 17.4 million people can still vote for Brexit, and they can make a start on the 2nd of May when the UK Independence Party is fielding candidates up and down the country in the English and Welsh local elections. Now, Mr. Juncker, if I heard you correctly, you said that there will be no extension to Article 50 beyond the 12th of April. And if there is no agreement on the withdrawal deal, then we leave by default and go on to WTO terms. I think that's one of the few things you've said I actually agree with. Good, let's bring it on. But if Britain is forced to take part in the European elections on the 23rd of May, then UKIP will field a full complement of candidates in England, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland. There will be no deals or alliances with opportunist parties and their daily allowance grabbing candidates. UKIP will stand on the policy of unilateral and unconditional withdrawal. No compromises and no surrender. And UKIP will carry forward that policy into the next general election. UKIP will accept no agreement on any other terms. We stand for a complete and total exit from the European Union. The struggle to set Britain free from the European Union continues. UKIP leads that struggle. Vote UKIP, vote Brexit.
Mr. Smith, Alan Smith, you were raising, do you want to make a point? I won't allow questions at all in this session, no blue cards. You have.
Rule 11, paragraph 3 of our rules of procedure to make a point of order about what was a flatly disgraceful speech from Mr. Batten right there. He does not speak for the people of the United Kingdom. He barely speaks for his own party, such as it still exists. And to use that sort of rhetoric in this house of democracy is utterly shameful. Can I suggest that you and the presidency think whether or not this house should continue to give a platform to these wreckers for their poison? Thank you.
Excuse me, Mr. Batten, I have the microphone and I will speak, and then I may allow you to speak. Can I say that I will definitely bring your issue to the President? I was also concerned about the use of another term, punishment beating. I find that a difficult term in the context of my own country. Sir, do you have a point?
Claims it that this gentleman represents a party which claims it wants independence, and yet it's happy to be subservient to the European Union. By all means, ban me and watch my vote go up in the United Kingdom.